بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لأهله والصلاة على أهلها وبعد السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته أهلا وسهلا بكم ومرحبا معكم أخوكم مجاهد علي. Hello everyone. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Inshallah ta'ala, today we will be learning how to construct sentences in Arabic. Basic sentences, inshallah ta'ala. In order to make sentences in Arabic, what we need some nouns. Okay? So let's look at the proper the nouns that we know, the very popular nouns. When we say nouns, we're talking about ism in Arabic. Allah. Okay? Allah. Allah. Another one we'll have is Ar-Rasul, okay? You know, we're going to start with Allah, we're going to start after that with Ar-Rasul. Ar-Rasul means the messenger, so let's write this down, okay? So first of all, Allahu, there you go. Allahu. We have another noun here, Ar-Rasulu. Yeah? Allahu Ar-Rasulu. What else do we know? We need more nouns, okay? I want to use the nouns that everyone knows. Everyone knows Allah, everyone knows Ar-Rasul, okay? Masjid, so let's say Al-Masjidu. There you go, Al-Masjidu. Let's have the dot a little bit more near. Al-Masjidu, yeah? Allahu Ar-Rasulu Al-Masjidu. Let's use a name, okay? So mashallah, brothers and sisters, we have a lot of names, okay? Let's use a brother name first. We'll use sister's name a little later, inshallah. Okay? Let's use a very popular name. Muhammad is a popular name, but I'm going to use Zayd, the only Sahabi's name mentioned in the Quran by his name, Zayd. Let me use this. It's a very popular name because when you study Arabic language, everyone gives you the example of Zayd, Khalid, Amr, and Bakr. Zaydun. So there you go. We got four here. Allahu, Ar-Rasulu, Al-Masjidu, and Zaydun. We got four nouns here. Okay, these are all known as, in Arabic we call them ism. Okay, so these are Allahu, it's not a fa'il, it's ism, Ar-Rasul, Al-Masjid, Zayd. You will notice that Allahu, obviously, is called Alif Lam. Ar-Rasulu is Alif and Lam. Al-Masjid has Alif and Lam. Zayd doesn't have Alif Lam. So in Arabic language, nouns, so is the noun, to make noun you need Alif Lam or proper nouns, okay, or pronouns, they are known as ism. Okay, now I want to give some information about Allah. When we say Allah, then when I say for example Allah, you're still waiting for me to say something else about Allah so that the sentence becomes complete. So what can I say about Allah? I'm going to say Allahu Wahidun. Allahu Wahidun. Ar-Rasul, the messenger of Allah. The messenger is Sadiqun. Allah Wahidun, Allah is one. Ar-Rasul Sadiqun, the messenger is truthful. The messengers of Allah, all of them, they don't lie. They're truthful. Al-Masjid, all the masjid, mashallah, you will all agree with me. Okay, when you say Al-Masjid, you say, Masjid is a beautiful place to go. Yes, so Al-Masjidu Jamilun. And I'm sure, even if you don't speak Arabic language, you heard the word Jamil before. Jamilun. The masjid is beautiful. Zayd. We're going to make this Zayd into a student. Zayd Talib. Zayd is a student of Arabic language. There you go. Zayd Talib. There you go. We just made sentences. To make sentences in Arabic is very easy. All we need is the nouns that we all know. Allah, Ar-Rasul, Al-Masjid, or your name, whatever, yeah, you're going to put it. And then what we need more nouns to give khabar about them. Khabar, some information about. Yeah, so Allahu Wahidun, Allah is one. Ar-Rasulu Sadiqun, the messenger is truthful. Al-Masjidu Jamilun, the masjid is beautiful. Zaydun Talibun, Zayd is a student. What are you noticing here? Do you see something? If you notice, then you will notice that The first ones, the first columns that we have here on my right here, all these are all nouns. These are all definite nouns. They have alif lam, or they're definite by its default is definite because Zayd is a proper noun. Yeah? And then khabar is also noun, but they don't have no alif lam. This is called mubtada. Mubtada. Mubtada means to literally means the beginning, because we have started our sentences with alif with noun. So if you start your sentence with the noun, mubtada, and khabar has to be without alif lam. So I cannot say al wahid. No, I cannot say as sadiq. I can't say al jamil. I can't say al talib. It has to be without alif lam, and it has to end with arikale dhammatain. Allahu wahidun. الرسول صادق المسجد جميل زيد طالب. Obviously, when you speak, you don't need to utter the last harakat. You don't have to say Allah واحد. You say Allah واحد الرسول صادق, because we're doing waqf there. That's different. Anyway, so to make sentences, we need nouns. Okay, one will be for mubtada, one will be for khabar. So next time when you read the Quran, keep an eye on. Does that noun, does it have alif lam? That means it's going to have something at the end without alif lam. Let me give you two examples from the Quran, inshallah ta'ala. In the Quran, Allah Azza wa Jal, He says, As-sama'u munfatirun bih. I'm just going to write the word munfatirun. I'm not going to write the whole verse. So there you go. As-sama'u munfatirun. Another verse, wal-akhiratu khayrun wa abqa. So I'm just going to write al-akhiratu. So it's easy to remember. I'm not going to write the whole verse. Okay, two verses of the Quran here. As-sama'u munfatirun bih and wal-akhiratu khayrun wa abqa. I'm only going to write the mubtada and khabar here. Look at this, very easy. So as-sama means the heaven. As-sama means the sky. As-sama, if you look at as-sama is with alif lam. So it's going to be mubtada. Munfatirun, okay, is without alif lam. So that's the khabar. This is mubtada, this is khabar. Okay, this is how you make, in Arabic it's called jumla ismiya. It's a nominal sentence. We need a noun. When you start the sentence with a noun, it's called jumla ismiya. Okay? And we need to have it with alif lam. Look at the next verse. Wal akhiratu. Let me just add the waw here because it's the, yeah? Waw means and. Wal akhiratu. Akhiratu, mubtada. Khayrun is khabar. Akhiratu is mubtada. Khayrun is khabar. Akhiratu, al-akhiratu is called alif lam. And khayrun doesn't have alif lam. Going back to what we said, we need two nouns. One noun will be with alif lam, other will be without alif lam. Unless it's a proper noun, okay? Then obviously you don't need to add an alif lam. It's already definite. There's no need to add the definite articles. Okay? Alhamdulillah, this is how we make jumla ismiya. Okay, we're going to move on to jumla fi'liya. Now, let us move on to verbal sentence. A sentence that starts with a verb. Okay? Let's start with something that's very important. Let's start with nasara. We need a lot of people to do nasara. Nasara. Okay? This is the past tense. Nasara means he one man helped. Nusra. Okay, an-nasr min Allah. We heard this before. Nasara. I'm going to use Zayd again because Zayd is very popular. I told you, easy to remember. If you remember when you were studying English, they used to use the name Fred a lot. In Arabic, they use Zayd. Nasara Zaydun. Khalidan. Zayd helped Khalid. Zayd helped Khalid. Okay, so in Arabic, this will be known as a verb. We're going to call it al-fi'l.
Zayd is al-fa'il, and Khalid will be known as maf'ul bihi or al-maf'ul bihi. Okay, right. So that, yeah.
Now, what is the meaning of fa'al? Fa'al is action. When you do something in Arabic, it's called fa'al. And the person who does that action, they call him fa'il. Which basically means that whenever you say fa'il, that means there has to be a verb before it. Yeah? And Khalid is maf'ul bihi, the object, the action is done to him. All you have to remember that in Arabic, when you want to use a verbal sentence, you need to have a fa'al and you need to have a fa'il. So Nasara Zayd, let's just look at that only. Nasara Zayd means Zayd help. We have another one. Okay, let's say, what if I were to use a feminine verb? Okay, so I'm going to say, if it's feminine, you will say Nasarat. Nasarat. Yeah, let's say Fatima. There you go. Nasarat Fatima. Nasarat Fatimatu. Now, Fatima helped. Nasara Zayd, Zayd helped. Nasarat Fatima, Fatima helped. So what are you noticing? You need to have a verb. And these verbs you will learn, inshallah ta'ala. Nasara, Nasara, Nasaru, Nasarat, Nasarata, Nasarna, Nasarta, Nasartuma, Nasartum, Nasarti, Nasartuma, Nasartunna, Nasartu, Nasarna. When do you use? You will learn all this. Don't worry about it, inshallah. Here, we need a verb. Whenever you use a verb, we need to have we need to say that who's done the action. Okay, who is the doer of that verb? So Nasara Zayd, Nasarat Fatima. You will notice that the fa'il has a dhamma again. Like Mubtada, we hear dhamma. Here you have to have a dhamma. Dhamma tells you that the doer of the action is this person. Nasara Zaydun, Nasarat Fatimatu. Yeah? Now the action is done to who? Is Khalid here? Therefore we need to be mansub. Nasara Zaydun Khalidan. Zayd help. When you say Zayd helped, the question will come, who did he help? Okay, so Khalidan, Zayd helped Khalid. Fatima helped, now who did she help? Let's say Nasarat Fatima to Maryam. Maryama. Nasarat Fatima to Maryama. Nasarat Fatima to Maryama. Yeah, here we have Khalidan, here we have Maryama. It's because you'll study something called غير منصرف, and that will be later on, inshallah ta'ala. One haraka is fine. For the feminine name, we don't say Fatimatun or Maryamun, just one haraka. Yeah, Fatimatu and Maryama. Nasarat Fatimatu Maryama means Fatima helped Maryam. So keep an eye on the Quran again. You'll notice there are so many verbs like in this pattern, Nasara, they might say Akala, or Qatala, or Dakhala, or Kharaja, or Dhahaba. You'll notice these kind of verbs. Okay? That means some action has taken place and you'll find someone has done that action. Let me give you two examples again from the Quran. Okay, so let's look into the Holy Quran and see if we could find a sentence that starts with a verb. Yeah?
You probably heard this many times before. Qatala.
Qatal means to kill.
Dawoodu. Wa qatala Dawoodu Jalut. Jaluta.
There you go. So qatala, just like what we've done, nasara, starts with the verb. After the verb, we need the subject, the one who done the action. That's Dawood here, and Jalut. You heard this before? David killed Goliath, yeah? Qatala Dawoodu Jaluta. So the fa'il has a dhamma, and the maf'ul bihi, the action is done to the person, has a fatha. There you go. Keep an eye on. Qatala Dawoodu Jaluta. Because if you change the haraka, that's going to change the whole meaning. وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ If you say قَتَلَ دَاوُودَ جَالُوتُ, then the Goliath becomes the subject and Dawood will become the object, and that's not correct. It's a mistake. Okay, mistake in every sense. It's a mistake in aqidah. It's a mistake in the sentence, and it's a factual mistake as well. So you can't say that. قَتَلَ دَاوُودُ جَالُوتَ. The subject, the file, has to have a dhamma, and Jalut. Okay, and the action is done to the person has to have a fatha. وَقَتَلَ دَاوُودُ جَالُوتَ. So there are so many verses in the Quran you'll find. خَلَقَ اللَّهُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ. Allah created the heaven and the earth. خَلَقَ اللَّهُ. Then you got الْأَرْضَ there. Okay, and many other sentences you could say that أَكَلْتُ تُفَاحًا. Or you could say أَكَلَ زَيْدٌ تُفَاحًا. Zayd ate an apple. Or أَكَلَتْ فَاطِمَةُ تُفَاحًا. Fatima ate an apple. And there are many other sentences. So, in nominal sentences, we need a noun. In verbal sentences, we need a verb. In noun, we need another noun to give khabar. And in the verb, we need someone who has done the action. Okay? And sometimes we might need the object as well. This is how you make sentences, inshallah ta'ala. We will learn more and more how to make long sentences and how to become creative in making sentences, inshallah ta'ala, in the future as well. As-salamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.